Vietnam, the university's FPT, and his name is Quy, and it talks about normal and tight Hilbert polynomials. And before Quy starts talking, I would like to remind you that actually Vietnam produces a lot of very, very good commutative algebras, and one of maybe the most famous one is with us and is one of the organizers of this beautiful conference, and is Chung. And I would like everybody to applaud Chung, because yesterday was his 70th birthday. And so also I would like personally, and I assume from all of us and from the whole commutative algebra community, thank Chung for the enormous work that he has done in Vietnam to produce such a wonderful generation, multi-generation, of very strong commutative algebraists, and for the connection that he has done on all developing countries for commutative algebra. So thank you so much for all your work. And I also would like to say that there is a wonderful conference in his honor at the end of June in Vietnam. So if you have the possibility to go, it's a fantastic country to visit as well. So now I'd like you give his talk, and let's go on.
Yeah. Thank you. First of all, I would like to thank the organization to give me a chance to present my talk. This talk is normal and tight Hilbert polynomial. This is a joint work with Li Chuan Ma. Two papers with Li Chuan Ma and a paper with Sapari Dupe and Zhuge Pema. Yeah. In this talk, I the first. I introduce normal and tight Hilbert polynomial. The second part is Thai Buxbaum, and is Thai Hilbert polynomial. The last talk is about normal and Thai Hilbert coefficient. In this talk, IM is a complete local domain of local ring of dimension D, and IMR is local cohomology. I is always M primary idea, and Q is X1 to XD is parameter idea. I and here is multiplicity and square length of I. I bar is integral closure, and I star is tie closure of I. We know that the length function of R mod I to n plus 1 become a Hilbert polynomial of degree D. We have this formula here, where E0 I is multiplicity of R with respect to I, and EI is Hilbert coefficient of R with respect to I. Okay, so now what normal Hilbert polynomial is I bar is contained in own integer element H in I. And if I bar is zero, so we have that a theorem of this say that we have a number C such that I to n bar contained in I to n minus c for own I, for own n. So the length function, the co-length function of I to n plus 1 bar become a Hilbert, become a polynomial of degree d in this form. This is the same Hilbert polynomial with the first coefficient is the same with Hilbert polynomial. So this is called normal Hilbert polynomial of R with respect to I. And E0 bar is normal multiplicity, and EI bar to N of N is normal Hilbert coefficient. So in now, what is Thai Hilbert polynomial? Thai Hilbert characteristic P. So of course this slide, I will skip this slide because it defies normal. So the title I star is by this formula. Yes, of course we know about that. And I is co-tie if I equal to I star. So we have that I contained in I star and I star contained in I bar. So if R is zero ring, so we have that the co-length of I to n plus 1 star become a polynomial of degree d. This polynomial in here with the first coefficient is the same with Hilbert polynomial. Okay, so this equals the Thai Hilbert polynomial, and E1, E0 star is Thai multiplicity. Of course, Thai multiplicity is the same with multiplicity for ZD ring. I star here is Hilbert coefficient. So if the ring is zero, we have that the first coefficient on of this is the same. But we have that the length of co-length of I plus 1 bar is less than or equal to the I to n plus 1 star, and of course it's ordinary function. So this means the second, the first coefficient of this is I1 bar of I always bigger than or equal to I1 star of I, and it is bigger than the I1 of I. Here, this we always have that. So, so for the normal idea, we should have said about the work of Siwoto in this one is if Q is parameter idea. So suppose Q is integral closed, so then the ring is regular, and the mu of of m over Q is bigger than or equal to 1. Always very special. So this is the next theorem we said here is the work joint work with Morales and Villain-Mazov perceptron. In here is says that Rm is ZDU equidimensional local ring. Suppose the I1 Q bar is equal to I1 Q. So the ring is regular and Z1. Okay, this is the same. It here we talk Okay. So now we talk more than this is we always have that the colon of Q is always bigger than the multiplicity of Q. Q is parameter idea. So we talk about the theorem of Hayasaka and Hiri. In that we have that the colon of Q to n plus 1 is always bigger than Z1. So if we have the equality for some n, then the ring is Cohen-Macaulay. Okay? So apply this inequality. Here we easy to set that the first normal first coefficient, Hilbert coefficient of this is non-positive. This is non-positive. This is theorem of Mada, Singh, and Verma. If Q is parameter ID of R, then the E1 key of Q is always less than or equal to zero. Okay? So what happened if we have equality in here? Equality in here. So this is a Van Coselot vanishing conjecture for E1. This is this conjecture was set by Geiji, Goto, Hong, Ozaki, Phượng, and Van Coselot in 2010. the theorem is that if Q is parameter idea of an unbit local ring, so if E1 of Q is zero, then the ring is Cohen-Macaulay. Ring is Cohen-Macaulay ZD. One. So what about the similar statement for integral clause or tie clause? So we have that the theorem of Goto, Hong, and Manda is that if ring is zero and equidimensional, so we have that the E1 bar of Q is always bigger than or equal to zero. Yeah. So we have something in here. We have that E1 of Q is always bigger than zero, less than or equal to zero. And if E1 of Q is zero, we have that the ring is Cohen-Macaulay. Yeah. Of course, this is we need the unbit in here. Okay. So now what the here Goto, Hong, and Manda both that so the E1 bar of Q be always greater than or equal to zero. So what about this one? The vanishing conjecture in here. And of course for tie clause of Q, what happened? And tie clause of Q is zero. What happened? Okay. So now here we should note that for any for integral clause, it's not only column for parameter idea, because for any prime idea I, we try Q is minimal reduction of I, so therefore we have that the E1 bar of I is the same with E1 bar of Q. So it's always bigger than zero in here. Okay, so now the theorem of Gotama and Mukunda in 2012. He says that if A is Zidiu Kohen Makulai, it is this Kohen Makulai of positive characteristic P, then if A is Eprasna, then I one star of Q is zero for some Q. We not true, not work, this theorem work only for Cohen-Macaulay condition. So the question here is about Professor Hunicki for work with, maybe he will ask Professor Verma in here, and here we public in a paper, joint paper with his student in this year. If R M is ZDU and equidimensional local ring of positive characteristic, if R is F Zagula, if and only if I star, I one star of Q is zero for some Q. Is it your question? Okay. Okay. So now we talk. Of course, for this one. Oh. Of course, in here, this question true for Cohen-Macaulay. So we have to consider this question for more general case. So the first case is for Bux boundary. We talk, remember that the length, the co-length of Q is always bigger than or equal to the multiplicity of Q. So define the Stuttgart and Vogel says that I is Cohen's power if and only if the difference is a constant for every, for own Q, for own parameter idea Q. Okay, so this is some definition of Bux boundary. This is some definition of Bux boundary. It's the same, almost the same of Cohen-Macaulay. But here is regular sequence. We don't have an M in here. Okay. if R is Bux boundary, so we have that the difference of the length, the co-length, and the multiplicity can be explicit by this formula, in terms of local cohomology. Okay? So here we talk about the definition of Peter Sensen, is that BR is intersection of Z module. For every X1 to XD is a system of parameter. So if ring is Bux bound ring, we have that. If ring is Bux bound ring, we can see that in here. So the M is contained in this idea. So if the ring is Bux bound ring, if and only if the BR is always bigger than or equal to the maximal idea M. Okay, of course, if BR is equal to M, R, the ring is Cohen-Macaulay. So let's talk a bit about Eprasna. Of course, Eprasna. So we go to characteristic P. Eprasna, if every idea, parameter idea is tight closed. For Eprasna ring, a theorem of Hochter and Hunicki says that this is normal and Cohen-Macaulay. And A theorem of Cohen-Smith is that if rational if and only if ring is Cohen-Macaulay and the Tiger law of Rero module, submodule of top Logan cohomology is vanished. So here we link two problems with that by a conjecture of Watanabe and Yoshida. Rm is unmixed local ring of dimension d of characteristic p. So it choose that for every parameter ideal q, we have that the multiplicity always bigger than the co-length of Tiger law of q. And if the multiplicity of q equal to the R mod q star for some parameter ideal q, then R is irrational. This is a conjecture of Watanabe and Yoshida. Of course, fortunately, this conjecture is true. This conjecture is true. This book by Goto and Nakamura in 2001. So you can see that in here, the Cohen-Macaulay implies Buxbaum, and Ebrasener implies Cohen-Macaulay. So what we want to find in here is that this is we want to set in here. In here, so it implies Buxbaum and this one. Okay? So there are partial answer for this problem by Bart, Ma and Schwitter and myself. Both of them are published in the 2018. Okay. So now, but this is a partial answer. This is a partial answer. So here, the R we define by parameter test idea. Parameter test idea is by this one, this formula. Parameter test idea. If R is F regular, R is F regular if and only if the parameter test idea of R is equal to R. R is F regular on function spectrum if and only if the parameter test idea of R is an imprimary idea. Okay? So, a question of Watanabe. This is a question of Watanabe says that suppose the maximal idea contained in the parameter test idea in here. So it choose that the difference of multiplicity and the co-length of Tiger law of Q is a constant for all parameter idea Q. Okay? So fortunately, in this, we confirm this conjecture, this question of Watanabe. This is a theorem with Li Chuan-Ma, published in 2022. If R is unmixed local ring of characteristic P, R is Thai Buxbaum. Here we define the new F singularity is Thai Buxbaum. If the difference of the multiplicity and the co-length of Q star is independent of Q, we call this Thai Buxbaum. If and only if the parameter test idea is contained in bigger than the maximal idea. So for Thai Buxbaum ring, we have that the difference of the multiplicity of the length of R mod Q star is by this formula. The same with Buxbaum, we have this one. Of course here, we fold this diagram. is that Aparasana implies Thai book bow, Thai spook bow, spook bow, and Kohen Makulay and book bow. Yeah. So here is example of Thai book bow ring. A book bow ring with zero Thai glow of zero submodule of Z1 is zero is Thai book bow. So for Z ring is Thai book bow. Z ring is Thai book bow. And Z is book bow and here. But here, if R ring is Z1, here we have that the R is Cohen Macaulay and the zero submodule. Thai glow of zero submodule of top local cohomology is K. So this is Thai book bow. Yeah. So we go to the okay. So now we go to the next part. We start study the Hilbert function of Thai spook bow ring. So Hilbert function of spook bow ring, we have a theorem of Sensei. We have this formula in here. So for the Thai spook bow ring, we have the same Hilbert function for Z1. So we have the theorem of Vema with Dume and Rama for a Thai spook bow local ring. So we have that the Golang of Q and plus one star is by this formula. And this formula we have this coefficient of this is here. So what about the E1 of Q star is zero. What happened? So you can see in here, we have that. If E1 of Q, E1 star of Q is zero. So you have that. The for this formula, E1 of Q, we have that. So the I 2m of R is zero. Okay, and the local cohomology. Yeah. This is the hit one. So I've got this conjecture, this question of Hunicki is maybe have some what we send because we don't have the H1 of MR of God. So we have that if RM is Thai spook bow of F2, so suppose I1 star of Q is zero for some parameter idea. So the ring is Aparasana. Yeah. Okay. So we talk about the last here we go to the Thai Hilbert polynomial for any ring. We generalize the work of Hayasaka and Hiri. If RM is here, we have that's a Golang of Q and plus one star is less than or equal to this formula. This formula in here. So we have that this one. E1 star of Q is always bigger than or equal to zero. So for Z1, we have Okay. So this one is always bigger than zero. In here. Of course, here for any primary idea, Q is minimal reduction of I. So we have that E1 star of I is always bigger than E1 star of Q and always bigger than or equal to zero. So it works for any idea. For any idea. Okay. So now we talk a bit about the similar work of Morales Chung and Villa-Majov. So the work of Chung, Morales Chung and Villa-Majov claim that E1 bar of Q is equal to E1 of Q. So ring is F regular. Of course, in here. So, our this if Rm is zero equidimensional of positive characteristic P, and suppose E1 star of Q equal to E1 of Q, so then ring is aprational. We have the same the work here, and so with this sound can extend for not only positive characteristic but also for mixed characteristic. Of course, I don't talk about this because I'm not familiar with this. this is for any balance C, big Cohen-Macaulay local ring B, so we can define the same way. By this one, so we have that E1B of Q is always bigger than or equal to zero. This for mixed characteristic. And of course here, we get I star of Q is always bigger than zero because B here. Okay, so the last theorem, I missed something. Sorry. The last theorem of the talk is we answer the here. The question in here. This one. We have that E1 of Q is zero, and if you leave R is regular and mu of M of Q is always less than or equal to 1. So the only question is about this one. We don't know at this time. So this is the question. If R is zero and S2, so suppose I1 star of Q equal to zero for some parameter ID Q, so then R is aprational. Okay, so thank you.
Let's thank Kui. And are there any questions for Kui? Yes.
Hi. So you were explaining this relationship between F rational and tag Buxbaum and Buxbaum.
Here it is.
Yeah.
F rational and tag.
Yes. That picture, the diagram. So how do F nilpotent singularity fit in that picture? F nilpotent is another way of
reading. Yeah, F nilpotent, but F nilpotent is not implies, of course. Here, but of course, F nilpotent is very close with aprational. I mean, of course, here we can think so for some nilpotent element and Frobenius. So, of course, but no direct relation in that.
And a second follow-up question would be, would you try to relate the nilpotent property with something similar as the this Tite-Hilbert polynomial, but you use Frobenius powers instead of Tite closure?
Yeah, sorry, I don't understand what you say.
I was wondering if you could try to mimic the construction of the Tite-Hilbert polynomial by replacing Tite closure with the Frobenius closure, and if that would tell you maybe anything about nilpotent.
You mean Frobenius closure?
Frobenius closure. Frobenius.
I'm not sure we can define Frobenius closure. I'm not sure. Because Frobenius closure may be very different.
Okay. Thank you.
Any other questions? Okay, then I would, yes. Mark? Yes.